I'm going to give you an example on how you can refinance a property in order to reduce mortgage payments and other debts in the case that a person has accumulated some debt. My name is Camilo Rodriguez with Mortgages Lab, and please know that we can do this type of scenarios anytime if you contact anybody in our team. The first thing I'm going to show here is this is an example. We say Speedy Gonzalez, for example, they have good credit. His wife is Minnie Mouse, and they're making $65,000 and $45,000 per year, which means that the family income is about $110,000. These are roughly their existing home details. They have property taxes for $120 a month, heating of $90, and they own, let's say, a condo or a townhouse for a $300 a month payment. For the approval purposes, we use half of it, okay? Now, let's say this family, I'm gonna go first to the mortgage. Let's say this family owns a home worth $600,000 with a $300,000 equity. So they have a mortgage of $300,000 on a rate of 5.2 with a 25-year amortization, and then they have a monthly payment of $1,779 per month. So this is their existing situation. In addition to this, I'm going to show here what the other debts they have, or other obligations. They have visas for $10,000, making $300 a month payment. They have a MasterCard for $5,000, making $150 payment. And they may have a car loan for $45,000, and they have a $550 payment. And this is causing their families to be a little bit strained, because all the payments add up to about $1,000 a month on top of their $1,779. So they have right now an outlay of $2,779. So what can we do in order to help them reduce the payments? So what we could do is, if we realize here, we have $60,000 of additional debt. And one option, and of course, this is just a video to show you what we can do, but when we do a real scenario, we'll troubleshoot all the different options. But one option will be to include these into the mortgage. So we need to increase the $300,000 mortgage by $60,000. I'm going to add another $5,000 for legals, appraisal, and a penalty, possibly that the existing lender will impose. But again, every mortgage will have a different scenario. So that means that the equity here will be reduced. Again, here we increase, if you see here it was 300,000, we increase it to 365 to pay this off, 60,000, and add $5,000 for other expenses. So in this case, we bring this to zero. This is how we're going to present it to the lender, okay? And that means that they're going to apply for a $365,000 loan on the same terms. We're not going to change this for now to make it simple. 25 years, 5.20 is the interest rate, and now the payments are $2,164, and they have zero payments on the other accounts because they were paid in full once everything is refinanced. That means that they will have savings of about $615. If they would need additional reduction on the payment, we could extend this to 30 years, okay? And in this case, the new payment will be $1,991, which means that the savings will be $788. Have in mind that there is pros and cons to everything you do in life. In this case, you have extended your loan for 30 years, meaning that you may have to pay more money to the lender, okay? But this would solve the short-term problem, bringing down your payments to $1,991, no other payments, versus $2,779. And in the future, I can show you how to prepay the mortgage faster so you can reduce as well the number of years from 30 to 25 or 20. Again, reach out to us if you'd like to see some of these scenarios done for you. My name is Camilo Rodriguez, and somebody in my team will look after you. We are with Mortgages Lab. All the best.